Michael Chandler.
So here he is, Iron Michael Chandler, making his much-hyped UFC debut. A lot of fans wondered aloud if this moment would ever happen.
I mean, at the end of the day, somebody has to be the best. Like, why shouldn't it be you? If you work hard, if you can truly say that you work hard and you try to be a good person and a man or woman of character, of good reputation, of someone who really is trying, that why shouldn't you deserve to be the best? Why shouldn't you see that goal, visualize it, and then take it? Because somebody else is going to if you don't. And so many times in life, people, you know, get things that they don't necessarily deserve. But if you deserve it, why shouldn't you take it?
You know, it's easy to be average. It's so easy to be average and average to be mediocre. You know, I posted something on Instagram the other day, and it was just a cool quote. And it said, only the mediocre can be expected to be always at their best. Because you can always be at your best when you're mediocre, when you're never striving for something great, whenever you're not outside of your comfort zone, whenever you're just living a life that has no goals, that has no drive, that has no big aspirations, no big hairy audacious goals, these goals that make people feel uncomfortable, these goals that make people doubt you. Whenever you don't have those, you don't have that exponential fear of being laughed at or failure or you know, literally everything coming crashing down does not define me. What defines me is truly trying to become my best self. And every single time I strap on these gloves, every single time I bite down on that mouthpiece, I'm trying to outperform my previous self. And I'm not trying to be perfect. And I'm not trying to be the best in the world. Becoming the best in the world is going to come with the process of becoming the best version of yourself. You know, I can only get to so high. You know, God only has this level at which I'm going to compete at some point in my life, at the peak, the pinnacle of my career. So just work hard and believe that you're going to get there, and don't put all this pressure on yourself.
Now I just have that abundancy mindset where there is no limit to what I am capable of. And it really is taking extreme ownership of literally every single day, seeking out people to admire, like listening to the words that you speak, listening to the other podcast or the other sermon or the other pastor, or the other motivational speaker, and realizing that if I can see that, then I can become some of that. Maybe I won't get, you know, maybe I won't be the greatest motivational speaker of all time or the greatest athlete of all time, but I can shoot for it and end up somewhere a lot further along than I would have normally been. You know, things become easier because you're constantly not putting limits on yourself, and then you start to see little successes, and then you pat yourself on the back for having that success, because now you are having the self-awareness to say A plus B equals C. It's black and white. If I continue to believe in myself, this practice, good things happen. Mm-hmm. This business deal went through because I had the confidence to see it through, you know? And things just, like, life just opens up and becomes so much more colorful and so much more vibrant, because now, instead of looking at yourself with that kind of small-mindedness, putting that ceiling right above yourself, you see nothing but blue sky, and the sky's the limit. Then you realize you need to stop being perfect and just try to be successful in that. Even if you failed, that failure was an event. It's not who you are. It's not a person, you know? Mm-hmm. And I think that has really resonated with me. That has really built this, it's not bulletproof, you know, but this armor that we have around us, and that armor has chinks in it. We all have our own insecurities, our own fears, our own limited beliefs, and our own limited mindsets, and I have thousands of them, but the more I can just pile positivity on it and more armor, adding more armor. And I think like this because I've had so many years to think about it, mull it over, and fail, and then triumph, and then fail, and triumph, and, you know, and just looking at it and almost kind of just making it not such a big deal. I used to put so much pressure on myself and make this sport so much bigger than it actually is. When really, we're all just trying to wing it. We're all just trying to figure it out. You know, work hard, be a good person, surround yourself with the right people, and good things will happen. But ultimately, most of all, just continue to believe that you deserve great things. Not that you're better than anybody else, but you do deserve probably more than you think you do. He said, failure is an event, not a person. Every single person that you look up to, your favorite person in the entire world, is a failure. has been at one point or another a failure, right? But that was an event that happened to them. And because of that, it made them a better person, you know? So failure is an event, not a person. Every single person that we've looked up to has gone from failure to the next failure to finally triumph, you know? And I think that's something that rings true to me because I had those failures and I failed so many times. But that doesn't mean I'm a failure. I'm actually a champion who has had some failures in his past.